Hi, my name's Susan Q. I'm 19 years old. Oh, this is my grandpa. Since his last stroke, he doesn't let go of that old pocket watch. I'm a piano student at the Music Conservatory. Well, currently working on the extremely difficult Rachmaninoff Concerto No. 2. What else is there to say about me? Shy, insecure, but definitely not weak. What can I do? I'm a teenager. Oh man, they've scheduled me for room number 9. It's the one with the old great room piano and the top lid doesn't open. What a nightmare. What's this? These look really old. Let's try to play them. This one is called Destiny. Whoa, what the hell? What is this? Who wrote this? Okay, Susan, you can do this. Watch. But who are these people? Thank you. Wow. So many questions. Let's try another piece. But this doesn't make sense. How is this related? Let's try this one. Try another piece. Let's try this one. Waiting for you. Good. It's a continuation. Thank you. the same watch again. But I'm sure it's my grandpa's watch. How did he end up with it? Is this something he's remembering? Weird. Okay. There must be more to this. Let's try and see what happens when I play Rachmaninoff. Come on. Show me something. Come on. What am I doing wrong? Why isn't it working? I don't get it. These songs are all muddled up. Let me put them in order. So, Destiny, Lost, For Soulmates, Life That's Not True. Waiting for You. Yeah, that's definitely him. This must be another memory. God, what are they doing to him? There must be something about this piano. Maybe there's something inside. Nothing. Everything looks normal. Oh. A serial number. I can try to look for the owner or something on my computer. Just one more song. Oh, it's the girl. Where is she? I'm awake. Where am I? There's nothing here. This room is completely empty. Do I exist? Am I real? Eyes closed, naked doors, empty frames, blank pages, locked doors. Silence moves in the bright light. Empty hearts slightly beating. I'm here. I'm real. I'm real. I look at myself in the mirror and see a completely lost being. Not belonging to this world. And then it hit me. Without foresight, not even a warning or truth re-entering my mind, I realized at that moment, right there and then, that all my life, I had been afraid. It's as if I have always existed, and forever's a really long time. Okay, let's try to recap. A woman dies and gets taken somewhere. The man grieves, goes mad, and gets taken to an asylum. My grandfather's watch appears, but he doesn't. Huh. Why is this piano showing me this? Who wrote these songs? Where did this piano come from? Thank you. there was no composer. Let's check out the serial number. Oh my God, that's the man. That's him. Thomas Moon was a pianist and composer who performed concerts of his own compositions, usually with his partner dancer Lyra Silver, forming the duet SilverMoon. Unfortunately, not many of his compositions survived. Almost all got forgotten over time, along with the tragedy surrounding his life. The composer and pianist was found dead several weeks after being discharged, and the world never heard Thomas play again. Time to get to the bottom of this. Imagine you have a bank account that deposits £86,400 every morning. This account does not allow the amount to accumulate from day to day. And every night, it removes any amount that was unused. What would you do? Wouldn't you withdraw the full amount every day? We all have such an account. It's called time. Every morning, it gives you 86,400 seconds. Every night, remove the seconds you missed. It doesn't allow you to accumulate from day to day. You can't borrow or increase the seconds you have. Each day, it starts again, and each night destroys unused time. The time you have is the time you have, and nothing more. Time management is done by you, and only you decide how to spend it, just like money. It's never a question of not having enough time for what we want to do, but only if we want to do it and where it fits among our priorities. Come on, Thomas. I'm cheering for you. Nobody understands what happened to you. Smell the trees, touch the colours, see and embrace the open doors, feel the earth. Come back to reality. Don't lose yourself. Oh my god. No. Why did Thomas write songs about his doctor? What does it mean? That's her guardian angel, just like Lyra had hers. So he gave the watch to Dr. Luana. But then how did it end up with my grandfather? That's the school caretaker again. I guess they were good friends. He probably put the music inside the piano and then locked it down. So Thomas actually recovered. He hit rock bottom, almost lost himself among the storm of events that threw him right where he should be. Came back and didn't seek or live a full life. I guess he just wanted a little peace. Thomas and Lyra have good reasons to feel good about how things turned out. They both overcame their own storm. The guardian angels are together. Perhaps they have some unfinished business. Grandpa. This is how he got the watch. My mum said he had work helping people at the rehabilitation centre. That's where he met Dr. Luana, who had the watch given to her by Thomas. And as a gesture of appreciation, she gave the watch to my grandfather.
Thank you.
Remember how I said that the guardian angels had unfinished business? I guess their plan, it worked. When they saw that Luana was falling into a deep hole, their plan was to somehow put her in a rehabilitation center. After being interrupted when she was about to take the pills and seeing her abusive husband in front of her, she was forced to change her path. Luana now lives in a new house with an ease of spirit so that she can go on helping others. Sometimes, fate is like a violent sandstorm that constantly changes direction. And you, being in the middle of the storm, do everything to get out of it. Because it hurts you. It makes you suffer. And however much you try to run away, it keeps chasing you, time and time again. Why? Because this storm has not arisen out of nowhere. It has something to do with you. This storm is you. It is something within you. So, the only thing you can do is to enter it and walk through it, step by step. Do not delude yourself. It will hurt. It will tear. It will remove all the dots you have joined, all the malice and all the tricks you have learned throughout your life to overcome difficult moments. Chaos and disorder embrace you like an enveloping dance, where you observe each, increasingly unable to set yourself free. But I guarantee you, as soon as it passes, you will not remember how you managed to survive, nor will you be sure if the storm really ended. But one thing is certain, when you leave the storm, you will not be the same person who entered it. And that is precisely the reason for the storm. Because the past is the past, and you can do nothing to change it. But the future, oh, this is yours, to write as you wish, every day.